So let's talk about the blue-green deployment now. We have learned services. And we have understood that services will use endpoints and talk to the pods. Using this, we can implement two deployment patterns. One is blue-green deployment, and later we are going to see canary deployment. Now, what is blue-green deployment first? Let's say we have blue deployment and that is already in production. It's absolutely working fine. That means there is a blue deployment and there is a corresponding service. Let's call it as blue service. The users are going to use that blue service and send the request and it's absolutely fine. No problem at all. Now I want to bring a new version of that application. Now when I want to create a new version of that application, the challenge is I don't want any downtime for this old and bring this blue version up, but that too, I want to first test the green version in production environment. That's the challenge. I can't do rolling update. Rolling update is not allowed. But why rolling update is not allowed? If I do rolling update, it will just one by one update everything. I will have no opportunity to do testing before I make that live. I want to first deploy my application into the cluster in the live environment, do the testing of it. And once I know everything is tested there thoroughly, everything is working, then I would like to switch all the load from the old version to the new version. That's precisely is blue green. Now the colors are only for reference. You can treat green as production and then later change it to blue, or blue as production and then change it to green. That's just for reference, but it's referred as blue green deployment. Blue does not mean production. Green does not mean testing, nothing. So use this deployment strategy to test new version of the application by a set of people within the organization in the production environment. That means I know who are the people who are going to do the testing. I will give the URL of my new application to those testers. And once they are satisfied, they'll make the application public. So let us see in practical how to do all these things. So first, I'll delete all my objects which I have. I've created load balancer service. Imperative command. So I have to use imperative command only for deletion. So now if I do get all, why is it still, blunder, sorry, this should be delete. Terminating, and shortly everything will be gone. Let's say I implement here blue-green.yaml. So first I will have my blue deployment. Nothing special. This is a regular blue deployment. I'm using Nginx. App blue, deployment blue. Intentionally, I've given these names blue, but when you do real time, don't call it as blue. Just know it in background that it's blue. That's it. for teaching purpose, for you to understand easily, I have given the names as blue. For this deployment, corresponding service. This is a node port service. Okay. High range port 32000. I can change it to load balancer also. But if you are doing on Minikube, node port becomes mandatory. Important is the label is matching. Selector label is matching. Now, let's apply this. -f blue-green.yaml. Cool. Kubectl get all. We know now a node port service is created on port number 32000. So go to the browser, localhost colon 32000, and we are able to access it. Nginx. The service is accessible. Perfect. Absolutely no problem. Next, what? What we'll do here is create a new version of this application. Obviously, the new version of the application is supposed to have new version of the image. Just to distinguish, I'll change all these. Blue, I'm changing to green. That means a green deployment with the green label. And we want a different image. I want to show you on view, it's completely different. So I'll use your HTTPD. Maybe you want to change this also. HTTPD. Green deployment, green label for the deployment selector, of course green label for the pod also, and the image is now changed. Obviously for this there will be a separate service. The label has changed, so give your green. Green deployment, green service. This name also will change. There cannot be two services running on same port. So this I'll change it to 32001. Save it. Both will be localhost. That's why the port number has to be changed. This need not be, because this is inside the cluster. The names of the service will be different. So port can be same. Inside the cluster, name is different. Name here is green, name there is blue. So port can be different. Port can be same. But this one, localhost, localhost. For blue localhost, for green localhost. Now what I'll do to access this service? Localhost colon 32001. This I will give it to my testers. So my testers will first, okay, I have to deploy this. New deployment created, new service created. So the testers now will go and try this URL. Localhost 3001. Something went wrong. Let's check. Now we have to debug this. Good that I'm getting error. Maybe I can find out a shortcut, and actually I can see the error here. it's unable to create the pods. It has got stuck. HTTP, okay, this is gone. HTTPD. Let's understand what is the error. Go to one of these pods. Describe. Successfully pulled image, pulling image, assigned image, started container, everything is good. Okay, it took a while. It took a while, and major reason for that could be I did not have that image locally. The image was downloaded from the registry. Now this will work. It works. This is the output generated from HTTPD. And this is, so end user is using this URL and they are happy. The testers within the organization are using this URL. All the testing team within my organization is using 32001 and testing the application. And now they find everything is okay. Once they find everything is okay, what should I do? The end user who is using this URL should now get this output. In technical terms, this service is sending the request to all the pods which are blue. The same service now should start sending the request to all the pods which are green. That's it. If my blue service, whose URL is known to the end users, using which right now they are accessing the blue deployment. If suppose I make changes to this, what kind of change? I'll have to simply go to the blue service and tell blue service, now your label is changed from blue to green. Blue service was referring to blue deployment, blue pods. But now the blue service will refer to green pods. Automatically it will start sending the request here, which will go to HTTPD. So thorough testing of the application is done locally. That's it. This has not changed. Green deployment not changed. Green service not changed. Blue alone changed. So now if the end user submit a request using this URL only, refresh it, we get HTTPD. Understand what we achieved. Before making our new version of the application live, I wanted to test my application by a set of testing team members within my organization in production environment. The application should be tested in production environment. After the application is found to be perfect in production, then I wanted to move into live. Live means map the live URL to the new version. And that's what precisely we have achieved using this blue-green deployment. Blue is production, green, and now I can delete. I can happily delete what? I can delete this. I can delete this. Because that testing is over. And I know everything is good in production with the new URL, with the old URL and the new deployment. I can decide and delete this. But remember, don't be in haste to delete. Let the users continue for a while. Using the blue service, they should continue for a while to use green deployment. So we should not delete the green, sorry. We should delete blue and green service. Blue deployment, green service now can be deleted. If there was a problem after switching from blue to green, if there was a problem, I should be able to go back here and again change the selector label of this, and that's it. And we are still going to have this working now. No problem at all. This will stop working. This will not work because that's gone. This is still working. So this is how you implement blue-green deployment using services in Kubernetes. That's all in this session.